Welcome back to the workshop. We've got two kits on the screen right now. The first two releases of the Trick Trike, 1 and 2 of 6. You can see that they're going to be coming out. They've got all kinds of cool features as detailed on the box. They have a customizing decal sheet, clear parts in 3 colors, and there's going to be this series of 6 if they do well. Let's take a look at everything that's in the box of the Taco Trike. That's the one we're going to be putting together first. Let's look at all the stuff that's going to be in there. Huge decal sheet. Let's see here. We've got orange clear, purple, and regular transparent. So we've got those set up like that. You've got those options when you build yours. The massive decal sheet. All water slide on there. All kinds of options. We got Tex-Mex. We got California Chili Chopper. We got, what does that say? Trikeadelic on there. We've got awesome wood grain. If you do the wild, wild wedge, that is so awesome. All kinds of emblems on there. We'll get it close. We'll go across. Sweet options, all kinds of customizing and decorating. Not a massive amount of parts. These should be very easy builds. We got the tires there. We got the white styrene on the table. On this one, we've got our big V8. This thing must go so fast. It goes back in time. We got wheel backs. We got cylinder heads. We got body halves with our part of our drivetrain on there. And mounting points. Awesome fenders sticking out there. We got our big seat there. Nice detail on the seat, leatherette or vinyl imprinted on there. We've got our floor, and we've got the other half of the body with all of our locating pins. We got a nice tight chrome tree here. I do like that the front fork and steering is all one piece so far with just small parts added. We've got lights. We've got super thin spokes and rear wheels. We've got headers all nice in one piece. Thank you for making my life easier. We got a two-piece differential there. Valve covers, oil pan, sweet accents on the chrome. And the final parts in the box are these gorgeous double-sided. We got flames on one side, slicks, and they say MH Racemaster on the other side. You get 2 of those beauties in there. And we get a skinny name branded Pirelli front tire. Actual has a name brand on it. It's pretty cool. So we're going to start putting those things together for the Taco Trike and come back and take a look. Just like that, it's painting time. We've got the interior done, the multi-piece, two-piece seat on the tray. Now we can easily paint that up and get a little bit of detail on every part in there. The pedals, the shifter and all that are chrome pieces, and they look nice, so we're going to leave those as are and glue those in place. We've got the block. I even put the distributor on because I'll paint that black instead of leaving it chrome. But we've got the block together with the cylinder heads. I will go ahead and paint that. We will attach the oil pan, the valve covers, and the velocity stacks later because those are chrome and they look nice, and I want to be able to have them separate and leave them as they are. This is the headlight mount for the fork, the front fork off the front of the bike. That should be body color, or at least on mine it will be body color. So go ahead and leave that on the tree, paint it up, and we'll get it ready to go. The headlights and taillights are 2 pieces of chrome that we put together. I did use CA glue and model glue to hold those together. So what I'll do is I will go ahead and give those my own chrome coating later, same as the differential. I sanded that down and then used super glue and model glue to hold it tight. Made sure that your metal axle, before you get it all done, make sure your metal axle will go in. So when you get that done, you can mount your wheels on it. That will be painted. Then the metal axle will be slid through it after it's put through the body. We're going to go ahead and get paint on the body. I glued the taillight mount on it. You can glue every part of the body together except for where the front fork goes in. There is a large pin there. You'll be able to press that together, get glue on the inside of it when you're all done, and have that go together real nice for you. You can see where that large pin is down there. That will press together. But the rest of the body, you can use model glue on, put it together, even these front areas here. You'll still be able to fit your interior in, and you'll still be able to get your engine in. As long as you leave that front end unglued, your engine is going to mount. Let's move it around here. Your engine will mount on these large pins. There are holes in the side of the block. We'll get that around there. There we go. Your engine will mount in those pins like so. See how it kind of is flexible right now? Once you glue your front end together, get that in. Once you get your rear differential in, that will line up with your engine on the bottom and hold that from dragging on the ground for you. And that's your drivetrain right there. Very simple, very easy to build so far. So I want to chrome my wheels, the backs of them. I want to re-chrome the differential and the light covers, so I'll be doing all those in chrome. Body color will be the headlight mount and the body itself. We'll do the engine and interiors in different colors for themselves. The rest of the chrome parts we're leaving alone. I took a black magic marker so I didn't forget. Blacked out the tips on the exhaust. Oil pan valve covers will be glued on separately. The fork is one large piece, and the supports for the fork here that go around the front wheel and all that, those are all one large piece, so we'll leave those alone. Anywhere we cut it off there, we can just touch it up with a Molotow pen or a silver marker, whatever you prefer. And the velocity stacks, all eight of them are alone. So we will end up doing black wash inside the valve covers. We'll drip some black wash inside those velocity stacks to get them to darken out. But most of the rest of this will all be as is. We can do some black wash in the front springs there. So let's get into paint. See the colors I've picked for the taco trike. That paint came out beautiful. On the body, that nice gold. I've already got the axle pushed in, the axle braces and the springs painted black because you really can't see them once that tire's on. And I have one of the tire and wheel combinations pushed in with the axle coming out the other side, ready to attach to the other tire. Obviously, I use the flame side because that is the look I want to go for. It says Race Master on the inside. From the back, it'll look great. You'll just see the back of that axle with the braces on there. We've got the interior done. I've got the decal on there, just waiting for it to dry and trim any little overhang. We've got our controls inside there. Looks awesome. And I do like the addition of that decal. I was going to do an all orange interior, but then I saw that decal on the decal sheet again and said, nah, let's get that painted up black seat with that on there. I did some red tinting on the one light that I want to use as a tail light. I'll probably use a mix of the different glass colors. You can see the engine looks great. That silver is drying up on the transmission. I did silver on the timing cover, black distributor, and we'll get our pipes in for the intake, our velocity stacks. We'll get our oil pan on. We'll get our valve covers. You can see how they're gonna look with that black wash, look almost like a magnesium style or brushed aluminum. We've got our headers ready. I just laid some black wash in between the two pipes there. Give them a little bit of depth. The oil pan I didn't touch at all. We've got fuel pumps and other equipment on the front. We've got the velocity stacks, which I black washed inside with that same Tamiya in there. Give us that darker color. What I will do is come back. We've got the forks all ready to go. Just paint the top little black there if you choose. Black wash the springs. The front wheel snaps right in and still continues to spin. It's a nice fit. And I'm super glad this is all in one piece to make my life a lot easier. I will finish assembling the kit. Before I put decals on, we'll come back for a look. The taco trike is assembled and it looks spectacular just as it is. All I need to do is attach the decals that I want to use on this one and give it a full coat of Future over the top of the decals, over the chrome, over everything to really give it a nice shine. But you can see that it is a cool looking bike. I use the orange glass on the back. I tinted out that tail light. We got the headlight in. The steering wheel still works. It still goes either way. I don't know how this thing is going to turn, but it does turn. Probably need, what, 40, 50 foot, maybe 60 foot turning radius on this thing. You're definitely not going to do a Y turn in a street with it. It is awesome looking. I bet you it just flies with that V8. So I'm going to get the decals on it, give it a coat of Future, and then we're going to jump into part two before we do the final reveal. Part two of the Trick Trike build video. Mailbox Chopper by Egg Big Daddy Roth. This one has a motorcycle engine in it instead of a V8. This is series number one. This is the first one. We did number two just a second ago. We're going to take a look at everything that's in the box. On this one, we've got some clear parts in threes, just like the taco trike. Clear, orange, and green on this one. Nice looking. This one doesn't have nearly as much glass as the other one. We've got a sweet set of decals. Huge Rat Fink decal. Ceiling panel for the roof if you want to use it. We got all kinds of stripes, flames, mailboxes, scroll work. We got turn signals and light indicators. We've got all kinds of cool little Rat Fink shifter, express post, beware a driver. What, we're faster than email, wanna race. Sweet decal sheet on there. You can make your own placard. We got three vinyl tires. We got that skinny little front tire like we saw in the taco truck, and this one has completely different rear tires. Treaded Street Meets, Goodyears, branded on both sides. You can highlight those white letters, you can leave them alone, whatever you choose to do. Beautiful tread on those. We've got a big chrome tree. These things got a lot of chrome on them. This is your exhaust. We've got engine halves, transmission cases, huge set of double front bars, and our handlebars are separate on this one, so you will have to assemble three pieces. We got little pedals that go in the side. We've got gorgeous set of wheels and a nice front wheel in two pieces, and our headers over there that looks spectacular. And for the white styrene on this one, we've got a typical motorcycle looking frame. We've got wheel backs. We've got a chain drive on this one with nice detail on it. You can even see little teeth on that gear. And then we've got the mailbox chopper body with that definite C cutout shape. We got our fuel tank and we got our interior panel. So I'm going to start assembling this and we'll be back for another sub-assembly show off. It's just as easy to reach the sub-assembly show off on the mailbox chopper as it was with the taco trike. We're going to be doing the frame separately since it does glue into the engine. The engine, like most motorcycles, becomes part of the frame, and so we can't start gluing that together. We do need to leave it separate. So I've got it on two trees here where I can start painting, and then just the neck will need a little bit of touch up on there. The chain drive, axle system, and the wheel backs will all be the same color, so I left those on one tree. We've got our interior that I want to do up separately from the body. We've got our tank, which I will be painting up separately. Our oil tank is assembled, and you can see that goes together with just a very small seam. We'll just say that's a weld seam. The engine does require a good amount of glue. I've got that nice little Honda engine all assembled. It is a little crusty because I use super glue, so you're noticing a lot of fogging. And the reason I don't care about that is I will be repainting this engine completely with some nice aluminum looking paint in the painting section. Now on the chrome tree, all that's really left is stuff that I'm going to be leaving completely chrome. We've got the headers and the exhaust. We got the wheels. We just need to black wash inside those, assemble the spokes. We need to black wash those springs in there. Our foot pedals will black wash. We'll paint the top of our handlebars here. These are our headlights and our gas cap. We're leaving that chrome. And the side cover on the engine, I'm going to leave that chrome as well, just for a little bit of a contrast to that nice four-cylinder engine block that we're seeing right there. I'm going to get everything into paint. Come along with. We'll see what colors I decide to throw. mailbox chopper so far seems to be just as easy of an assembly as the Taco Trike. They're both fun kits, and we hope to see all six of them coming out so that everyone can enjoy the different variations. I'm not very familiar with them at all, so I can't wait to see all the different ones coming out. Now, you can see a lot of the work I did. My suggestion, the manual wants you to put the fork in the frame, attaching the engine and chain and the gas station all later. My suggestion is, and it's working out very well, glue the engine into the chassis first on one side of the frame. We've got these nice locating holes. You can see them, they go all the way through, two there, one there, with the cross members on the engine. I glue one side in entirely, and then once that glue is dried, we glue the other three holes in. While we're doing that, we use a nice little clamp to clamp the neck together so that it held it in perfect place so it didn't become misaligned. Then I did the rear axle, got that glued in, lined up the sprocket with the side of the engine. Once that was glued in place, we took off our clamp and we have a perfectly straight frame. Then I glued the tank in place to hold the frame even more. You can see it run through those two rails. There's two rails and two pins underneath there that it glues onto. Has the oil tank right underneath it. That really stiffens up your frame, makes it a very nice strong structure. We got that color shift paint on there, which looks pretty cool. It seems to be going between a gold chrome and a green in person. I'm not sure what it's doing on camera. A lot of times these paints aren't the most amazing on a camera because the parts are so small on models, but in person it does look pretty cool as you rotate it and turn it. Kind of goes from a gold, green, black chrome effect and all that. Once we have that in place, I press the side chain guard of the transmission in. That's just a press fit on this kit, at least for me. Once I had paint on the engine, that shoved in real tight, didn't need a drop of glue, looks good underneath. And then our frame is all done. For the forks, what I did was I went ahead and instead of gluing the main fork into the neck like that, then attaching the suspension and the upper part of the front end, I glued it all together right now. We did my black wash earlier. You can see I glued the two ends together. They still open up to fit the front tire just fine. We'll be able to get it in there without any issue at all. I glued those all together and clamped them again so that they held tight. There's two pins in the front that will hold those really skinny parts together, so don't worry. There's two pins back here. We line everything up. Then all we have to do, using this little part of the fork, that center rod, it's very easy to just take the neck and pull it apart, see, just enough to get it in there, and when you let go it pulls itself back together. We don't have to worry about any glue. The frame tightens itself up. It's a little fiddly, and that's why I did it my way. The manual wants you to put the fork in right away and start attaching other things and just cement the very bottom of the fork. But as you can see how small that is, I knew I'd glue everything together and to my hands. So I did it that way, and it's working out well. The tires look, or the wheels look awesome with that black wash inside there. Hard to hold them, but get that black wash in there, darkens that up, leaves the chrome, and we glued our backs on there. All that gluing, once there's paint on, I just use dollar store super glue. Works awesome. One bottle lasts quite a few kits. If the nozzle ever clogs on the dollar store super glue, you just throw it in the trash. You don't have to lose a $5 bottle of super glue. Painted the seat up, did a nice little black wash in the grid there. That looks awesome sauce. Did black around it so it stands out. That will be in there. You'll be able to see it. It'll stand out nice and strong. Got the body itself all done up in the color shift, so you can see that. And I've got that green window glued in the back. The color shift paint and the black gloss coat tend to pull away from sharp edges, so you'll see it missing on some of the seams or along the edges. You don't really notice it too much, but you'll notice it pulling away from some of those sharp edges. I could have alleviated that probably with going with a black primer first, then the gloss coat, but I didn't. I went right with the testers over the white, so it is what it is, and it looks fine to me. We got our front wheel assembled. Looks awesome. That is just a press fit into that tire. There is no glue used on that. I didn't want to muss any of that chrome up. All that's left to be attached to the vehicle are the four headers, the four exhaust pipes, the upper handlebars. The headlights, which I installed the glass with Mod Podge, you just brush it in with a small brush, and that will hold it tight, and the gas cap. Same way that I attached the rear window in the cab, I use the green one on that one, and the clear headlights, because you have those three color options. I just use Mod Podge to hold it in. It dries in 15-20 minutes, and if you make a mistake, you rub it off with a Q-tip. Touching up everything on the chrome, I've been using a Sharpie marker to touch up any sprue points. We've been using Tamiya Blackline Accent to touch up anything, and Jet Black Craft Paint to paint around the seats and touch up any other parts that we needed to cover up that had been exposed. I'm going to finish assembling the whole kit. We'll come back for a final reveal. The Trick Trikes are back out, and we've got two built up here in 1/25th scale from MPC. Thanks to the peeps at Round 2 for sending these over, the first two in the series. Don't forget, there are six total. Collect them all. They're all going to have awesome features, improved decals, the awesome features you see here. We've got the Taco Trike, which I've done up in the Tex-Mex decals. I really like the ones that were on the box. The mailbox I did a little different. Instead of doing a three-color scheme, I went with the color change paint, used the original decals, they do have new ones in there, and threw a Rat Fink on the back, but I didn't go as heavy on the decals with the mailbox because it's a smaller one and it was a more clean design, whereas the Taco Trike definitely needed the free delivery fast service emblems, the Tex-Mex emblems, the 800 number, the little taco emblems, I just loved it, and you have more plastic to play with around there. They are excellent kits. I love the fire print MH Race Masters, and you can also, of course, flip those around if you just want drag tires. The wheels in both kits are gorgeous. The different style tires, I love that one's got a V8, one's got a four-cylinder bike engine. It's just so cool to see the variation, and I can't wait to see the other four. I don't know anything about them, so I'm really excited to see the other four that are coming out in this line. Now, don't forget, no matter which way you build any of these trikes, in each one, you're going to have a massive sheet of decals left over for all kinds of customizing. This one was in the mailbox chopper, and this one is in the Taco Trike. All kinds of decals and emblems and stuff left over for you to use and build. You don't have to use any decals. You could go complete paint. You can do what you want. They're a little bit of a delicate build, so I recommend them for someone that's got at least two, three kits underneath their belt, but otherwise they go together well and the fit is excellent. You can see we don't have any odd stances, nothing sitting funny. The steering still works on both of them when you assemble it, and if you follow those assembly tips that we've gone through with both of them, you're going to have an excellent time without any issues. And make it yours. Customize it. Build for you. Always do it how you want. Go with your colors. Don't put the headers on. Put the headers on. Put them on facing up, getting them blowing out the side. Do the bike up with a different type of exhaust you want. Bend it out of solder. Enjoy these custom things. They're going to look awesome on the shelf. People always love the delicate looking models, and you can see that you can build these quickly and easily with some simple tips that I've thrown into this review. Thanks for watching the workshop. Excited to show you what's coming out for 2020. We will see you at the next review.